Okay, so we've crossed the road immediately adjacent to the stand we were just looking at, and we're in what at one time was essentially the same stand. Yet the Deschutes National Forest conducted extensive treatment efforts in here, and largely those treatments comprised of salvage of trees that had died or trees that were being infected. And so again, I would not point to this stand as being a great way to stop that beetle outbreak, but what it did was create a much, much lower fuel bed, and now we have a lot less likelihood of severe wildfire in here. It does beget the question though, what's going to happen in the future? So as you can see behind me here, this stand has an abundance of lodgepole pine regeneration. This regeneration comes in two forms. It comes in advanced regeneration, which is what was here when the treatments were done. And then it comes in the form of new regeneration that has come in since that treatment. These are going to grow up into essentially an even age stand. Now we can see here, there were a few large trees that survived the outbreak. And you can see the orange stripe on this tree indicating it was a leaf tree at the time the treatment was done. So these large trees are providing the seed source. We know that this bare, relatively unoccupied ground behind us is going to continue to add lodgepole pine to it until it looks very much like it did prior to the outbreak. So management needs to make a decision then as to how we're going to handle these stands. What we've seen with mountain pine beetle is you can manage even age lodgepole pine, but if you do so, you must clear cut on a periodicity that precludes the outbreak from starting. This is not always possible. So do we manage uneven age management? And those of you that have had applied ecology know that, well, lodgepole pine is probably not a species well suited to uneven age management. We can thin aggressively and maintain a lower density of lodgepole and carry that lodgepole to an economic rotation. It will be less likely to be attacked by beetles, but that does have inherent costs with it as well, because most of the thinning that would be done in stands like this would be low value, chipwood, fuel wood, or simply pre-commercial thinning where the material would be left on the ground. So managing mountain pine beetle here on the Deschutes has centered around a variety of techniques, salvaging the timber that was in areas of concern is one technique. What we do in the future will be up to public input and different land use and other factors that affect how we go forward with forest management.